Hi subscribers and viewers, I want to welcome you to Owubi channel. So in this video, I'm going to discuss a topic that has been going on for a while now in the field of Wi-Fi technology. It seems a lot of folks don't really know how to deploy a Wi-Fi network infrastructure. So kindly sit back, relax, and watch this video attentively whilst I give you some in-depth knowledge about deploying a Wi-Fi network infrastructure. Thank you. So these are certain questions I organized to help you with how you can easily deploy a Wi-Fi network infrastructure either in your house or in an organization. Okay, and so the first question I asked was, or mostly the first question most folks will ask is, what is a Wi-Fi network? And I define a Wi-Fi network as the establishment of a wireless connection between two or more devices, such as access points, mobile phones, computers, PDAs, and etc. Okay? And then the next question I asked was, how do we deploy a Wi-Fi network infrastructure? First of all, before you actually deploy or have the mindset of deploying Wi-Fi network infrastructure, you need to actually go to the premises, either the office or the house. Do a quick survey of the place. Look around, look at possible cable paths you might need. Look around, if it is a story building, you need to find a path where you can easily run your network cables from up down to the server room. After having the idea of deploying a Wi-Fi network, the next thing you must think of is to survey, to go and look around for yourself how such a structure could help you to easily deploy your Wi-Fi network. Wi-Fi network deployment is an interesting and a tricky way of deploying a network infrastructure. The reason is that there are numerous phases that is needed to deploy a Wi-Fi network infrastructure, which I'll mention and explain. So these are the phases you need to go through to have a successful Wi-Fi network deployed. The first phase is, what is the number of Wi-Fi users you are looking at? What is the number of Wi-Fi users you are looking at in terms of the office space and the staff there? If you consider home users as well, you are going to look at the number of users which are going to use this Wi-Fi at home. So number is key, okay? And in this case, if you have about 50 users, okay, these are the number of users which are going to use the Wi-Fi in your office premises due to expansion, okay, and backup in mind, you need to always go beyond the specified number. So example, if you have 50 users, you should be looking at 60, 70 or plus users. Okay? The next one is, so these phases are going to help you in getting the best equipment and the best bandwidth to manage these users. The next question is, what is the bandwidth needed for such Wi-Fi users? Bearing in mind how heavy the internet usage might be. Okay, in this case, the kind of bandwidth you are going to get or buy from your ISP should be enough to be able to handle this number of users. Else, you might have a lot of disadvantage using this Wi-Fi network with regards to downtime in data usage and then slow internet, of which you wouldn't like this to happen. The next one is, what is the best router needed which is capable of effectively providing network services to this number of users without any hindrances? Yes, to get your network going, your Wi-Fi network deployed successfully, you need a kind of router which will manage the network, which will provide network resources and services to these users. And so you don't, I wouldn't recommend you going for a lower version router which will cause a lot of obstacles to this your users. You actually need a good router for that matter. You need a router which is capable of handling this number of users, providing all the services and resources without breaking down. The next one to ask, or the next point to add, is what is the best access points needed which will be capable of handling this multitude of users, bearing in mind expansion. So in this case, you know, in network deployment, you always have to make room for expansion for future sake, so that when that time comes, you know, be found wanting, where you might even end up spending a lot of money which might not be needed, right? And so in this case, you need an access point which is capable of, example, handling 100 users and over. Okay, and so if you assess the environment and the number of users might be 100, you need a router, a network router, which will be able to handle this 100 and over users. You need an access point which is capable of handling this 100 and over users, right? So you need these two, they must be paired together, they must work together. The router and the access points must always go hand in hand, right? So if you have about, let's say 1,000 users, you should be able to divide these 1,000 users among the number of access points you might need to be deployed. Mind you, perhaps one access point can be able to handle about 200 users. Right, so you need about 5 of these access points to be able to handle these 1,000 users, and even you might need more than that. So the next point is, you should consider getting a quality copper network cable, because you will not enjoy the Wi-Fi experience when you have downtimes in your low or have slow network. And that's the best advice for you to have your good Wi-Fi network deployed with no lags in the internet connectivity. You need a very good quality network cable which is made of copper. Nowadays you have copper coated metals that are made to believe that it is a network cable, but actually it's not a quality network cable. So you need a good copper quality network cable. The next one to talk about is, after the Wi-Fi hardware deployment and installation and configurations are done, the last thing you must bear in mind is security of your Wi-Fi network. You need a very good password configured on the router and your access points to prevent any sort of intrusion. Okay, perhaps you can even employ the likes of firewall, access control list, and other advanced features in controlling users, right? So this is the best way to actually, or this is the brief in-depth way you can actually deploy a Wi-Fi network. So always bear in mind these phases, this point I have articulated in this video, and then you have a successful network Wi-Fi deployment. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. But we've come to the end of this video. I really hope you had a gist on how you can successfully deploy a Wi-Fi network infrastructure. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe, share my videos, like my videos, and your comments are expected too. Thank you. Lest I forget, I'll be coming up with a video on how to set up a point-to-point Wi-Fi connection infrastructure. Thank you for watching.